Okay, so I just moved into this new house. Of course, my dad is improving the HVAC. So right now...
I'm on vacation.
Yeah, exactly. So right now you are adding a thermostat into my upstairs.
Right.
Because I only had one downstairs. So what's the project that you're working on?
You've got one system in the house, one furnace and air conditioner, and we are dividing that. We're adding a second zone upstairs. And so... if you've seen any of our previous videos, you can see what we're doing there. But there's actually one designated duct going upstairs, one for the lower level, so that makes it really easy to split. However, we don't have a thermostat up here. So what we've done is we're putting this thermostat in the master suite up here. I've gotten up into the attic and I've identified this wall and drilled a hole through the top header of the wall. And I dropped down a piece of string and I made a little fishing tool, and really just in a matter of a couple of minutes I was able to fish it out. If you can, get your hole centered in the wall as close as you can to where you're wanting to mount the thermostat. Wow. Rather than trying to pull a wire, drop a wire over here, it's a little more difficult, but you can do it. This is gonna go all the way to the basement and hook up to the zone panel downstairs. Right. This is called an Ecobee thermostat. This is the new one. So we pulled a wire all the way up from the basement from where your furnace is, then pulled it down into the wall here. And so we've mounted this in your master suite. The way this works is we program it much like a regular thermostat, but this thermostat also has the capability of overriding that automatically. It's got sensors that sense movement in the room. You can have a program in it that says, I want you to maintain an occupied temperature today. But if it senses that there's no activity in here, it knows there's nobody here and they're not moving around, it will override that. Conversely, you could be here at times where, wait a minute, there's not supposed to be someone here, so the temperature goes to an unoccupied temperature. And now somebody stays home sick or something like that. It senses movement in the house. It will automatically maintain temperatures. Also, each of these thermostats, the one upstairs and downstairs, has a secondary remote sensor that we're gonna, for instance, you've got a home office on the second floor that you use a lot. We're gonna put that sensor in that room, and it's gonna always be looking at the, obviously the master suite here, and then make adjustments as far as what the other space needs as well. So we're not just sensing temperature at one given point.
Just in the master. So it knows that I'm in my home office in the other room on the second level, and it will cool that space to
even though
what I want it to be.
This particular spot right here might be satisfied.
Right.
If you're not in, if you're, for instance, we're in the cooling mode, if you're warmer than that in the other room, it will actually override this thermostat.
And while that makes sense, because while it's still upstairs, it still has different facing windows, and it could be a totally different feel in there.
And we were talking about how we'll utilize that downstairs, you know, in the winter time. We may put that remote sensor in the far third level of the home, just so it is sensing kind of what's going on down there.
Yeah.
And run heat.
Even it out.
So there'll be times we'll use that in the winter time to kind of even temperatures out as well.
So which with each thermostat, it has, so the sensor on the thermostat, and then it has a secondary sensor that you can put just somewhere else.
Yep.
That's cool. And so then in this house, I have two thermostats because you've zoned it for two zones. So I basically have four sensors throughout the house.
Right.
Keeping me comfortable.
Keeping you comfortable.
So, okay.
Yeah. It is connected via Wi-Fi, so it can pull up local weather and it's all those things. So I wouldn't be surprised if it even adjusts the heating and cooling settings, you know, based on what is the forecast, you know, that kind of thing.